tightly packed seated stand. You know, the Bury fans in and around us, Bury in their white and blue home kit, Colne in all red. With Colne's goalkeeper in fluorescent yellow, Jack Atkinson in all green. We're underway, long ball forward from Lafferty. Finds the head of Briggs, but he's dispossessed out left-hand side, cut across towards Lennon, and that's cleared well by Devaney. Back into the area, Devaney with a header, and that's going to roll through for a Bury corner.
Oh, well, maybe kept not. It.
It's been kept in, back into the area, head of Benito Lowe, Sajal Hassan blocked. Now that is going to be a corner.
Yeah, terrific play on the left-hand side there.
People still coming in. It's on the corner of the area for Colne, shot across the face of goal from Weaver, and that's going to be a corner. Local community to enjoy with their sights in Walshaw and Brandlesham. You can head to their website. As a shot comes in from Lenehan there, you can head to their web. You can hear every complaint when the players come over towards this side as Briggs flicks on towards Benito Lowe. Good opportunity here, right hand side, looking to get the cross in, but it's slightly falls short. You can have the throw in from. It goes short to Lafferty. Colne weren't expecting that. Cross for header from Rowney. It is Briggs, and that's gathered well by the goalkeeper.
Yeah. I'm not sure that was the intention of it, but Lafferty just sort of pinged in a dangerous ball. But it was a lovely head on, and then just unlucky for Briggs, couldn't quite get his foot on it.
Forward, dinked ball forward. As they look to get on the attack here, it's gathered well by Jack Atkinson.
Best bit of football that from Colne on the right wing.
On Saturday, and they were delighted to see his goal.
Wow. What a competitive debut that was.
Into the area it goes, and near header there, and Benito Lowe's been penalised for a foul on Devaney there.
Lowe, and won a free kick that he had no right to, really.
Cross into the area from Insaka. Palmer wrestling with Win Stanley at the back post, and it would have been a few yards forward. It's across the bridge, and there's the opening goal. Well, the keeper will be disappointed with that one, but he palmed it out, and then the ball came back across, and very much like he was on Saturday, just a few yards out, and Andy Briggs has the opening goal. That's Colne 0, Bury 1.
Striker's goal, that, wasn't it? Just gobbled it up. He's not going to miss that. But all came from that sort of probing ball from the left-hand side again, and Saka. And
it the respective that they did at the respective clubs last season is El Hassan now with another opportunity. Back out to Palmer, back inside towards El Hassan, but that's blocked by Win Stanley. And then he hacks down Darius Palmer halfway inside the Colne half, and it's going to be a free kick opportunity. Chris Rowney, one player in the wall for Colne. Rowney does go short to Tinnan, who gets a left-footed cross in towards the back post, tries to find the head of Lafferty, and Colne head that out for a corner.
Nice tip.
And Rowney with this corner into the area, headed clear. Now the head and Briggs and appeals for handball.
Very vocal appeals, very vocal.
Jack Tinnan and Andy Briggs definitely saw something. I also believe celebrating his birthday today as well, Gary. Happy birthday to you.
Got to be a booking that, hasn't it? I think for Owen Watson, the captain.
To get forward here to Colne. They'll be looking to get forward. And again, Watkinson in on Obeng. Free kick.
Yeah, he's got to be careful, of course, on a booking. I mean, that was never a second yellow card. But
this free kick into the area and a calamity in the box. Massive shout for a penalty, but ref goes goal kick. Oh, that's cleared. Colne, I've got a good run of possession there, and interesting decision there for against Devaney there. Trying to get forward. So look to get it forward here, El Hassan. Looking to run through, looking to get in there, but just slightly falls short. Here's El Hassan, Insaka, it's a twist and turn as he gets in there, and it's going to go out for a corner.
Getting a bit,
Well, there could be a substantial amount of added time for the injuries as well, as Benito Lowe nearly has an opportunity to run through on goal there. Here's Briggs. Oh. Looking to get a pass off towards El Hassan and over the bar. Again, good work from Berry, from Briggs out towards El Hassan on the left. But
yeah, we're regularly looking for that angle cross.
Saka, he finds Lenehan. Back out to El Hassan. Briggs brings it down and shot from Lenehan. I'm not seeing any tweets to say that they've sold out just yet. Here's El Hassan. Ball through towards Benito Lowe. He's onside. Round to the goalkeeper. Takes the shot. And there's Berry's second goal.
Absolutely fantastic. Classic. Very much like his first goal on Saturday. Lovely through ball. And at Mack as well, he rounds the goalkeeper. Beautiful skill from Lowe. And there's absolutely no doubt with the finish. What a brilliant time to score. Right in injury time in the first half. One for Briggs, one for Lowe. Pretty much perfect first half, Adams.
Yeah, indeed. Berry leading by those two goals. You can't really complain. I mean, the pedigree that he had coming in from Withenshaw. It's like him and Briggs, you can't complain, as El Hassan's got an opportunity here. He's looking to turn, he looks to get it to Palmer, and there's the third goal! And we talk about a clinical first half. As we hit 4 minutes of added time, Colne 0, Berry 3.
Cracking again, very similar break. Just the pace they can't deal with, Colman. Lovely little... Well, you've got to say that El Hassan was so unselfish then. I thought he was going to go for goal. You're 2-0 up, it's the last chance of the half probably. But no, squares it, and he gets his teammate Palmer his first goal of the season. Can't deal with these. The defenders just can't deal with them.
And that's half-time here at Holt House, and Berry with quite a convincing lead going into the break. And referee just makes his final checks, and Colne get us back underway. Saka. It's Colne look to get through there, and a shot comes in, and it's well saved by Atkinson. So Colne have got an opportunity here, and Atkinson does well to nip in front of Forshaw. Colne have got an opportunity here through the captain Watkinson. He's storming forward. A great challenge in there from Jordi and Saka. Out to El Hassan now. Berry on the break. Left-hand side. That steaming pace of Sajad El Hassan on the left-hand side. Crossed into the area towards the run of Andy Briggs, but probably 2 or 3 yards too short there. Colne, though, have possession. It's across the box. They look to go for a shot and can't have a goal back. And it is the skipper, Watkinson, with a great shot from the edge of the area.
Good goal from Colne, well worked. Berry just a bit too far away from the men. He just stood off them too much. And that will just give Annie Welsh's men something to think about, you know.
Header there is Gilboy. Looking to steam through the Colne defence here. Takes the touch, looking to turn it onto his right foot, but Colne dispossess. That's Apple Rose. The man that was appealing for a foul there, as Nsaka gets it to El Hassan, who gets it back out to the right-hand side after receiving it from Gilboy. Gilboy with an opportunity, and it's going to run through back to the goalkeeper.
Lovely football there from Berry. El Hassan flicked it over his man.
He did get booked. Does Colne have an opportunity again through the captain?
Fantastic that from Nsaka, getting back. He was miles ahead of the defence there, Watkinson, but he was in his own half just, so he wasn't offside. But there was Nsaka, came from nowhere, and I don't think Watkinson knew anything about that either.
From that?
Yeah, just overhit it a bit. Brooks was going to be really in on goal then.
So, Colne have an opportunity here, and big appeal for a penalty there against Lafferty, and a second opportunity skied over the bar. It's 2 of 4, isn't it? As the Colne free kick comes into the area. There's the header, and a great save from Jack Atkinson. He was headed clear as well. Finds Harry Brazel. Nsaka. Oh. Back down there. And Burrows. Chance for off Harry Brazell, who's in acres of space. Ball over the top towards Briggs. Looks to control, and he does. Looking to find the options. Out to back to Brazell. Now Lenehan. Just encouraging, I think it's Nsaka that's take the throw in. Header there from Colne, and there's the final whistle. After what's been a bitty second half, Berry picking up three goals in the first half before Colne getting that one back just after the hour mark. Back-to-back wins for Andy Welsh's side, but it's also back-to-back defeats for Paul Weller's Colne.